are colonized. We are not Indonesian people. Mining companies, logging companies, they just come in, destroy. We say, oh, this is good place, this is place to worship. They say, oh, you need to believe in God. Don't believe on trees and mountains. It is the same as here, for example, when people come into your house and bring weapons and then bulldozers, and they say, we want to move this, your bedroom, we want to move the television, we want to build a house here, just like that. It's the same thing happening in West Papua.
November 1969, within this particular room, the General Assembly took note of the result of the what so-called referendum or PEPERA or the Act of Free Choice. I'm more familiar with the Papuans as the Act of No Choice, and that is the reason why I feel some trembling when I walk into this room. At the General Assembly room of the United Nations. It brings me back, way back to the 60s. I always think of my father, who has spent many, many months and years of his life in New York to fight for the right to self-determination, meaning the letter and the spirit of the New York Agreement, that that agreement should guarantee freedom of expression, freedom of opinion, freedom of gathering of every individual, every West Papuan, to speak out by the end of 1969, whether they want to be part of Indonesia or they want to be politically independent.
I'm 40 tahun lebih. Nah, untuk daerah selatan, setelah tahun 1984, ada pengunduran besar-besaran, sehingga ini sudah bibit-bibitnya. Nah, untuk penyelesaian masalah Papua Barat. Jadi ini salah satu pos pertahanan di mana kami pertahankan sampai dengan bagaimana ada dukungan-dukungan politik untuk penyelesaian masalah Papua Barat. Oke. Okay.